Now, the next topic is trigonometric ratios of some specific angles. Now, these specific angles are 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. Now, one thing that you should know is that we are only studying the trigonometric ratios for acute angles, maximum up to 90 degrees. So, what happens over here in these is that these are the values of sin A, cos A, tan A, cosecant A, secant A and cotangent A, and for various angles those are 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. Now I have drawn this table. This table will be available all over the internet and in your books, and this table follows a very interesting pattern, which is like 0, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2 and 1. The values of cos are just the opposite for this. You have to just memorize all these values. But it is very easy to remember because it always follows a pattern. If once you've gotten the values of the first two lines, the third, that is tangent of A, now one thing more that you should know is that tan of A is equal to sine of A upon cos of A. Always and always, tan of A will be equal to sine of A upon cos of A. How? I'll just tell this to you. We have a triangle, let's say ABC, okay, and over here, now tell me what is the value of sine of A in this. Sine of A will be equal to perpendicular upon base, that is BC upon AC, correct? BC upon AC. What is the value of cos of A? Cos of A is base upon hypotenuse, that is equal to AB upon AC, correct? Now, according to the formula, what is the value of tan of A? Tan of A is equal to perpendicular upon base, that is again BC upon AB, correct? Now, if you see over here, just to verify this, tan of A is equal to sine A by cos A, correct? Now, if I do this, we say sine A by cos A is equal to BC by AC, BC by AC multiplied by AC upon AB. Am I correct? I've just reciprocated it and multiplied it. That is what division is, correct? So this is BC by AC into AC by BC, and this AC is cancelled. So this is equal to BC upon AB, correct? That is the value of tan of A. So tan A, you guys should remember, is always equal to sine A by cos A. Now this is going to help you construct this table for yourself in your examination. So what happens in this is that when you have to follow the value of, when you have to calculate the values for tan of A, what do you do is you just divide the values of sine A and cos A. So you just have to remember the first two lines, that is sine A and cos A. Or I should say, you just have to remember the first line, that is the values of sine A, because the value of cos A are just, if you see, 1 comes here, root 3 by 2 comes here, 1 by root 2 remains here, 1 by 2 comes here and 0 comes here. So if you only remember the values of sine A, you'll be able to write the values of cos A. Then division of sine A by cos A gives you tan A. Cosecant A is 1 by sine A, or the reciprocal of sine A. Now coming on to the values, those are not defined. If you see over here, sine A by cos A, that is 1 by 0. So you all know 1 by 0 is not defined because it is infinity. Anything divided by 0 is infinity, or we call it not defined. Same way over here, cosecant of A is equal to reciprocal of sine A. So reciprocal of sine A is 0, 1 by 0, that is again not defined. Same way over here. And same way over here. So this is something upon 0, that is not defined. So we were doing cosecant of A, that is the reciprocal of sine of A. Same way secant of A, that is the reciprocal of, this is secant of A, not S-E-T. This is secant of A. So secant of A is the reciprocal of cos of A, and cot of A is the reciprocal of tan of A. That is how we find these or construct this table. That is how we remember the values. Just remember the values of sine of A, and the rest will be calculated. So now, coming on to that question over here. we'll use this figure in the question itself. Now, this question says, in triangle ABC, right, angled at B, AB is equal to 5 centimeters. So, AB is given to be 5 centimeters and angle ACB is equal to 30 degrees. This angle is equal to 30 degrees, okay? Now, we have to determine the length of CB and AC, correct? That is what is asked. So now we are given that angle ACB is equal to 30 degrees and AB is equal to 5 centimeters. Now if you see over here, we are given these two things. Using these two things, we have to calculate the values of BC and AC, the lengths of BC and AC. Now tell me one thing, what is the relationships that have the base in them, or this is the perpendicular for angle C, AB is the perpendicular, correct? Because it is on the opposite side, right? It is the perpendicular for angle C. So what do we have to do over here is we have to find out the ratio which has perpendicular in it. So sine A or sine C, I should write, is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Am I correct? Sin C is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse, which is equal to AB upon AC, right? So this gives us the value of the AC. How? Because sin C is equal to sine of 30 degrees, which is equal to AB is 5 upon AC, correct? Now, what is the value of sine of 30 degrees? From this table, sine of 30 degrees equal to 1 by 2. So, 5 by AC is equal to 1 by 2, correct? So, AC is equal to 5 into 2, that is equal to 10 centimeters, correct? Now, we have the value for AC. Now, what do we need is the value for BC over here, correct? What is the relation that has the base and the perpendicular in it? That is tan A, correct? So what do we do over here is tan A is equal to perpendicular upon base, am I right? Or I should write it tan C over here because the angle is C. So tan C is equal to perpendicular upon base. What is the perpendicular for angle C? That is equal to AB. And what is the base? That is BC, correct? Now we have the value for AB, that is equal to 5 centimeters upon BC, correct? Now what is the value for tan C? Tan C or tan of 30 degrees from here, if you go through this table, that is equal to 1 by root 3. So 1 by root 3 over here is equal to 5 by BC. Correct? Now, what is the value of BC from here? Is equal to 5 root 3 centimeters. So, we have the value for BC and AC.